December 2012. On screen, the famous political drama Homeland. The viewers were shocked to see something that came straight out of a science fiction. Vice President Walden, one of the main characters in the storyline, was killed. The villain had hacked into his pacemaker through a wireless channel and caused a heart attack. And this wasn't fiction for long. Barnaby Jack, the famous computer security expert, showed that he could hack into pacemakers and insulin pumps in front of a live audience. And around the same time, United States former Vice President Dick Cheney had asked his doctors to disable all wireless connections to his chest implant because he feared that there could be an assassination attempt through medical device hacking. Fast forward to March 2019. The US Department of Homeland Security warns that many of the Medtronic devices are vulnerable to security attacks. These attacks can happen to me, to you, or to anyone with a wireless implant. We need to stop this. And this is where my research comes in. My name is Vaibhav Chatterjee, and my work relates to human body communication. Instead of using wireless channels, we use the human body as the communication media. Using our technique, the low-frequency electrical signals, like the ones used in pacemakers for control and battery information, they stay confined within the body. This means that an attacker cannot snoop into your personal data as the signals do not leak outside. The data can only be transferred through touch, and hence you can transfer all your information once you touch your smartphone, your smartwatch, or your laptop. This also has numerous real-world applications. For example, I can unlock my laptop or my phone without a fingerprint sensor. I can exchange business cards or send confidential military information simply by shaking hands with someone I trust. And you know what's the best part? Right. We don't need to use any wireless channel for this. I hope that this technology will revolutionize the security of medical devices. And remember that episode in Homeland where the Vice President's pacemaker was hacked? Rest assured, it will still remain a fiction. Thank you.